Some one-of-a-kind watches are set to be auctioned off tonight right here in New York. Robert Frank joins us now with more on their famous owners. You got Jack.
We've got...
You got Jack to do that for us, and he said Squawk Box, I think.
He did.
That's his watch. It's in the center. Rolex has a long history with the PGA and great champions. I think Rory's the latest, I think.
Isn't it? And it's one thing for a celebrity or a sports guy to own a watch for a certain period, but this was Jack's watch for 50 years. I'm going to tell you about it. It is considered one of the most famous watches ever in sports, and tonight it could be one of the most expensive ever auctioned. Jack Nicklaus's gold Rolex Day-Date comes up for bidding tonight at an auction held by Phillips in association with Bacs Russo. Watch experts say it could surpass the $17.8 million that Paul Newman's Rolex fetched in 2017. Now, collectors have been waiting decades for Nicklaus's watch to come on the market. It is the only one he wore for more than 50 years, and it was on his wrist for 12 of his 18 major trophy presentations.
I didn't play golf with a watch on, but it came on as soon as I came off the golf course. My watch and wallet came back on to me. So every time I'm with a trophy, every time I travel, I've got a picture with me with the watch. And it was part of me.
All of the proceeds for this sale will go to his charity, the Nicklaus Children's Healthcare Foundation. Now, the collectible and secondhand watch market is expected to top $16 billion this year as the auction houses and online marketplaces like Watchbox and Watchfinder attract younger buyers. Also selling tonight will be Marlon Brando's stainless steel Rolex GMT Master, which, get this, he wore in filming Apocalypse Now, and it's got his signature on the back.
Very cool.
Bidding on that starts in the six figures.
That's pretty awesome.
Yeah, it's signed in the back,
and then we've got that to go for.
And six figures.
That's bidding on that will start in the six figures. The Nicklaus watch is going to be in the millions. We don't know whether it's going to be over 10 million or not. And then the one on the far left is the watch that Robert Downey Jr. wore as Iron Man in Avengers Endgame. That's the Erwer watch. A lot of people, the younger people,
what'll that go for?
That's estimated at $30,000 to $60,000. Right. So that's more.
And
affordable.
Is there security with you today? Right.
There
now?
Is. We have a watch guard. We have two watch guards.
Two watch guards.
It's like millions of dollars of watches.